Let's dig in a little more to see how the number of features that you use in your algorithm is connected to the bias variance dilemma. Remember what we said before is that a high bias algorithm is one that pays little attention to the training data and is kind of oversimplified. It just does the same thing over and over again, regardless of what the data might be trying to tell it to do. On the other hand, an algorithm that's too high variance pays too much attention to the data. It doesn't generalize well to new situations that it hasn't quite seen before. It's basically just memorizing the training examples. And as soon as it gets a new example or a new data point that's not exactly like one of the training examples, it doesn't really know what to do. Another way to think about this is that it's overfitting to the data. Another thing that would be fair to say is that high bias algorithms tend to have high error on the training set. So in the case of a regression, for example, this would mean a low R squared value or a large sum of the squared residual errors. High variance, on the other hand, might have a very, very good fit to the training data, but a bad fit to the test data because it's not generalizing very well. So as soon as you give it something new, it starts to run into problems right away. You usually expect to do a little bit better on the training set than you do on the test set, but high variance means that you're doing much better on the training set. But high variance is when you're overfitting to the training set, you get much worse performance on the test set. So here's a quiz question for you. Let's suppose you have an algorithm that's only using a few features in it out of, say, very many that you have available to you. So maybe one or two out of dozens, potentially. Without knowing anything more about the exact problem or the exact features that you're using, do you think that this would be more inclined to be a high bias situation or a high variance situation? Click which one sounds right to you.